And you said that you grew up in Etha. What's up with the Jeremy? Major Rap Scene. I'm fucking with my nigga Dead CO. Or is it Dead CO?
Dead
CO. All right. Could you explain the name? Let them know it's DEZ, the CO part, you know?
Yeah, actually, you know what I'm saying? Dead CO, you know what I'm saying?
Corleone.
Yeah, since I broke it down to CO, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It was actually the first rhyme I ever wrote, you know what I'm saying? I had a song called Chopper Tune.
Chopper Tune.
When I was like 17. My first line on the bitch, then CO, all of y'all, don't give a fuck. You know what I'm saying? You hear me? So, ever since then, you know what I'm saying? The song had started taking off and shit, motherfuckers started saying this shit, so I just kept it at CO.
So, was the Des, but that's a nickname? Or?
My name is Des.
Yeah. Alright, so it was just a simple transaction.
Yeah.
So, you was talking about Etha, Louisiana?
Etha.
Alright, you said that you grew up in Etha.
Good
little drive from here, huh?
Yeah, about an hour and a half.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
And what was there a lot of growing up? Was there like a Walmart down there, like any super centers, the stores down there?
Bro, they ain't had shit down there. Ain't shit down there, but like a mental hospital, you know what I'm saying?
Sound like a trap. What schools did you go to coming up?
See, I was born in Baton Rouge, and I moved to the country when I was real young. So I went to Jackson. That's like a complex school, you dig? Like elementary, middle, high, it's one big school.
Yeah.
I went there, then I moved to Baton Rouge. I went to Southeast, Tanglewood, then I went back to the country. And then I came to BR, you know what I'm saying? You know, doing my thing.
So when you was in school, did you have any focus on sports, or was you just like, you know what I'm saying, not really into sports?
Yeah, I played basketball.
Played basketball?
Yeah, I was a point guard. Yeah,
so was you a scorer or a passer? Let's ask that.
I was a scorer.
Yeah.
I could dish that bitch too, but I was a scorer, man, because the jump shot went.
Yeah.
The jump shot still went.
Automatic.
Yeah,
sure. All right, and at the time that you was playing basketball, were you writing raps?
Yeah, like I used to always write raps. Like since I was like about 14, I got in trouble every day at school, you know what I'm saying, for writing raps. I fucking doing work and shit. I'm over there writing raps and shit.
Yeah,
I write verses, at least two verses of class, you know what I'm saying? That's all I did. So, and it used to be in the class, you know what I'm saying? This
with the beat.
That's
shit,
how
yeah.
I started. He was just gassing me up like, man, you
so you kinda home. knew what you what the fuck. What it was hitting for awesome shit, huh?
It's a shout out to a couple of my homeboys that gassed me up. If them niggas would have never told me that I went hard, I'd probably never be rapping. You know what I'm saying? Just me just freestyling or this stupid shit that I thought. The nigga like, man, shit, make me rap. Yeah. The nigga kept telling me this, so I'm like, man, nigga keep saying that shit, fuck it. I start taking it serious, you know what I'm saying? I started with a group called 629 Boys.
629. And did y'all separate or y'all still together?
We separated, yeah. You know what I'm saying?
So, With that first song, you said that you was like, yeah, CO, Carly O, you know?
What the fuck is this $1 million deals on the phone?
Yeah. So, where was that drive to? Like, how did that come about? You was just finally like, fuck it. Like, what age?
Bro, this the craziest shit, man. Shout out to my nigga Mike Dawg.
Shout out Mike.
You hear me? OG. Because there was a nigga, by 16, I moved into my own spot, man. My brother, we had our own apartment in the country, you know what I'm saying? Like a little townhouse or whatever. My dog came to my house one day with a CD. This was like in like 2001 and shit. Niggas really wouldn't come in the hood when people was on a CD on wax and shit. Then man, I got my song on a CD.
I'm
like, hold on, what you say? I'm like, you got your song on your CD? Oh, man, how you do that? So we chopped it up. He never gave me the plug on,
how to do it.
So a nigga I was working with at McDonald's, shout out to Johnny Domino. Say he doing his thing to be all I fuck with that nigga.
Man, shout out to
Man,
I did him a couple times.
Man, that nigga working at McDonald's exactly that girl though. And he said, man, I got this youngster. He young, but then they got a studio, he record. You know what I'm saying? Shit, y'all need to fuck with him. I heard y'all music, y'all need to fuck with him. I'll bring him to you. So, little, check this out. He took us to Glen Oaks off Prescott, you dig? So we walk in there, it's four of us. Me, Buck, D, and Raymond. Shout out 629, but we walk in that bitch. They got like four niggas in there, by our age or older. So we like, man, okay, which one of these niggas the one that record us and shit? We chilling. A little nigga coming in this bitch about this tall, about 13 years old. walking the bitch, made the beat. We like, man, who this is? Nigga called himself Goldie. Mm-hmm. But that's Lil Wayne the Champ now. Shout out to Lil Wayne the Champ, man. That boy Champ was grinding when he was 13, man, making beats, recording G shit. I seen it. That nigga did my first song, man. Much love, you know what I'm saying? That shit tripped me out, because this nigga made the beat right there in our face. Recorded that bitch, mixed the bitch. We took it to the country, they went crazy, bro. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like the whole hood was going to chopper tool. Holler, you a fool, get hit with a chopper tool. Be on the 5 o'clock news, knock me off your Reebok shoes. Yeah.